Maxine Waters has a complete breakdown during speech. Damn this president. I guess Trump broke her. By Amy Moreno for TruthFeedNews.com. California Representative Maxine Waters had yet another epic breakdown weekend while speaking to the Teamsters Local 630 in Los Angeles. We're in a difficult time in this country, Waters said as she rattled off all of the terrible things President Trump is doing to the country. Robust economy, jobs, lowest unemployment in 18 years, world peace, soaring approval rating, and then defeated, yelled, damn this president. Guess what? I guess that impeachment thing isn't working out so well, huh? Maxine Waters at Teamsters Union, Local 630. How these people clap for this idiot is beyond me.
And Secretary Treasurer, Lou the young Marston. We got that right. Okay. I'm pleased to be here with you. Always happy to work with you on behalf of the teachers, organized labor, and workers. And I know that this is not Patrick Keller's union, but I want you to tell him I was here. And I want you to tell him, don't call me at 6 o'clock in the morning. You know, he gets up early, and he starts calling around. And so we always know about 6 o'clock, that's family hour. So, you've invited me here today, and one of the things you wanted me to talk about is really a very serious issue. I understand that union attorneys have filed a private Attorney General Act claim on behalf of several female employees of Vistar Division of Performance Food Group. And I've heard that this issue, and heard all about it from your local 630 Secretary Treasurer, as I told you, Lou is out there talking about what's going on, as well as I've heard about it again from Patrick Keller. They have explained to me that for more than 2 years, Local 630 has been negotiating its first collective bargaining agreement, but that major sticking point in their negotiations is pay parity. For warehouse workers at Vistar Distribution Center in East Drupal Street in Ontario, which is represented by my colleague. Less than the rates paid to employees of the opposite sex, but substantially the same work. At the federal level, in Congress, I'm working with my Democratic colleagues to address gender income disparities. This year, I joined Rosa DeLauro. She's our
gender disparities.
Remedies for workers to include the National Women's Law Center, union membership.
I want to get to the point.
We're in a difficult time in this country.
Wow.
We're almost at a constitutional crisis.
Really?
In the United States of America. We're at a constitutional crisis because we've got a president the likes of which we've never seen before. You know, some people think his antics sometimes are funny, sometimes cute, sometimes unusual, and they say, well, you know, he's gonna learn to become presidential. That's a lie. He's never going to be presidential. He's never going to be presidential because he does not respect the Constitution of the United States of America, and he is no friend to organized labor. And let me just say this. I know that some of our membership in various areas of the country said, well, you know, we don't think that we've gotten a fair shake. We don't think government has paid enough attention to some of our rural communities and our little towns. But I want you to know this. Whether it is health care, or whether it is food stamps, or whether it is any of the issues dealing with the least of these, and whether it's issues about whether or not our government and elected officials are going to support the right to organize and support the right to bargain, it has not been Republicans. It is always Democrats. We've been there for you. We're going to stay there for you. And damn this president, we're not going to let him destroy organized labor.
You know, and these idiots are actually clapping. These idiots are actually clapping. It is insanity at its finest. I mean, are they crazy, what she's saying? The Democrats want to do away with the Constitution. What is she talking about? Whether it's food stamps and health care, who's going to be paying that for that, Maxine? You are? Oh, I guess she's going to be paying. Of course, you want everybody paying for these union dues where you can put the money in your pocket, actually. Well, the top elite, so to speak. That's been going on for years, and Trump's putting an end to that from what I gather here. Anyway, this woman is out of her mind. People that follow these people, they're actually out of their mind. So, you know, Maxine, the jig is up, so to speak. Your years, decades, I should say, long of money laundering and taking out of the system through other people's hard work, those days are over. People have woken up, and a couple of idiots that you have in the audience isn't going to cut it. Let me know what you guys think in the comments below. And again, thank you so much for watching.